Hello, hello everybody. Hope you're all well. Welcome to the penultimate, aka the last but one, Big Brother's Little Brother. We're doing this show live, but if you're watching at 10:30, it's a repeat, so look upon this as a fantastic build-up of tonight's eviction. A piece of history, if you will. In just over an hour's time, at around 8:20, the lovely Davina, who should see rehearsing right now, will be announcing that someone has been evicted. The housemates will be given a few minutes then to adjust with the news after being told who that person is. It will then be the housemate with the least number of votes, obviously, and then have 90 minutes to say their goodbyes. So near, yet so far from that 70k. But the headlines so far, the housemates last night were treated to a slap-up, tonight we're treated to a slap-up party to celebrate passing this week's task. They chose the theme of Last of the Mohicans, so Big Brother gave them everything they needed to play cowboys and Indians.
Dude, how can I still look gay and I'm dressed like this?
You just do.
How do I?
You're very gay.
How do I?
But you look more gay. We're drawing on three and you've got to say, does it first?
Let's watch, who do you think is first? One, two, three.
No, you went way before three, you cheat!
What a good smell. One, two, three. Dean.
Oh, no way!
It's over.
I'll do it later. Sorry, Brooklyn.
Great fun had by all then. Okay, quite a monumental day for us on Big Brother's Little Brother because we're joined by people we haven't been joined before. Normally we just hash out the same old guests. It's family and friends, Vanessa Dean's partner, Steve, Elizabeth's partner. Can I say boyfriend and girlfriend instead? Because I hate that partner thing.
No, boyfriend's fine. I'm a boy.
Good. Michelle Bryan's sister and Mark Helen's brother. How are you all feeling, guys? All right?
Excited.
Fabulous.
Excited.
Yeah. Air of anticipation.
Very cool.
You really? You've seen it all before?
Okay. No, of course.
Mine, Mike, sorry, 9 weeks ago, did you expect to be sat here today?
No, in honesty, no. Before she came in, I thought she'd do very well the last bit 2 weeks, because I find her immensely annoying. So,
have you tried to chuck her out of your house several times?
I've tried. In the end, I had to move out. Okay. Do you know what I'm saying? So, no, I thought we'd be up and down here for a couple of weeks and then she'd go, so, but I think she's done really well.
Because when she was nominated with Penny, were you surprised that she got through that week?
No. I thought she survived Penny Week, but I thought she might go perhaps the week after or something, so... Mm. But she's done really well.
Now, Michelle, Brian worried about his family's perception of him. Did he have anything to worry about?
Absolutely nothing to worry about. Obviously, Mum has flew over from Ireland, which he's totally not expecting. And so whenever he does come out...
He must be kind of expecting it. He works for an airline. He's got down to the last four.
No. Right. He's with Ryanair 3.5 years and none of us have actually flew with him at all. So she's here. I think that says a lot. And I'm sure Brian will be more than delighted.
I bet the whole
them.
Town's behind him as well, are they?
Unbelievable.
Really?
The whole of Ireland, by the looks of things this morning.
Okay, Vanessa. Every Wednesday, Dean's taking time out to connect with you. Were you doing the same?
Of course.
What do you do? Because he's got a very easy way of just like two sticks.
Two big sticks.
He's got the V. Yeah. What do you go like that?
Yeah. I've got two bigger sticks.
How do you do the D?
It's called distant healing. And you just sit and think and project images of love and stuff like that to each other.
Hello! Because I was there watching the monitor yesterday and I just thought, I don't know what you were saying.
Yeah.
Make sure I got a warm bath when I go home.
I think I did hear him say, put the pork chops on.
Yeah, that's what I said! Oh, Yuri Geller moment! Okay, Stephen, it seems to be two different views of Elizabeth. In the house, she's caring and calming, but the public seem to, you obviously think, misunderstand her, and she's got a game plan.
Hasn't got a game plan at all. She thought she was only going to be in here for a fortnight, so she thought she'd come to enjoy herself for the first fortnight. It's a big surprise to her to find herself where she is. No game plan at all. Mm. But
why do you think the public have got it so wrong then?
I have no idea. I've been completely baffled because, in fact, I've read the tabloids too. It's a new experience for me, and I've found no hostility in the media at all, apart from one or two. I don't know. She's portrayed as scheming. She's not. She's the most straightforward person I've ever come across.
Okay, brilliant. Now, Michelle, has Brian done anything that's just made you want to like curl up your toes with embarrassment?
I suppose the day of his birthday, the night of his birthday.
Why?
His backside was broadcasted.
Surely I'd imagine that's quite an annual affair with Ron and his birthday, though.
Well, I'm not used to it anyway.
And Steve, do you think Elizabeth will mind? I mean, with the publicity and so forth, and especially thinking about the photos that came out.
What photos?
The nudge, nudge, wink, wink, how's your father photos.
Why should she be embarrassed about that?
She shouldn't be embarrassed. Would she mind, do you think?
No.
Did you plan it at all, or?
It was thought about.
Ah, oh, Steve! You're a cold fish. Why? What was the reason why?
Why not? The papers are full of pictures of pretty girls. Why not Elizabeth?
Fair enough, I guess. All right, okay. Mark, well, I just, you know, my sister, she's a pretty girl, and, you know, I don't know whether she'd like to do that sort. Moving on. Mark, Helen says she's changed a lot. Have you noticed any difference whatsoever?
No.
Apart from the tan?
None. Yeah, apart from the tan and the red face. Not really. She does a lot more in the kitchen. Porridge making, maybe. Besides that, no, the mouth still works, doesn't it? So,
do you think she's matured at all?
I think she, maybe a little bit, yes. Mm. I think she was talking the other day about she might want to move out of house now, but, you know, out of the same house from her mum and stuff, so maybe a little bit, but not a huge change, no.
Mm. And what is it exactly that you think? I mean, are there any sort of instances where you thought that, you know, she's really done well here, she's kind of come of age?
I don't know. Just generally, I think she's a bit more confident than what she would be normally be. When she first entered, she was quite quiet and a bit withdrawn. Now she's more expressive and a bit more loud. So self-confidence, maybe, yes, I'd
say. Okay. Now, Vanessa, we've heard that Dean's invited to play at V2001.
Ooh, yes.
He's just going to be over the moon about that, isn't he?
He is, yeah.
Okay, well,
yeah.
I mean, were you shocked when you heard?
Not really, because when you see him play, he just looks great on stage. The band are really good.
Does he like that at home, though? Because he's, I mean, I love him to bits, but he's always got that guitar. Right?
Yeah, but that's what he does when he's fed up or he's bored or whatever. So it's his only thing that he's got that he can relate to home to. And
but when is it at home that you ever get just like, oh, put it down?
No, yeah.
Take out the drums or something?
Never, no. No, I don't, because he doesn't play that much at home. Because he's always got stuff to do.
And are you going to get hooked when he gets out?
Hooked?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you?
Oh, yeah.
You're going to bring like your forward, so it's going to happen quite soon?
It is going to happen quite soon.
Oh, excellent. Yeah. Okay. And lastly, guys, what's happening in your hometowns?
We've got fantastic backing from our local radio station, BR&B.
Lovely.
Local press have been very supportive, Edinburgh is a very sort of town, so they're not too excited.
Every business in Rattangan, totally behind Brian 100%.
Newport, Elvis, John Lennon, ABBA, all playing tonight, getting the town centre in Newport. It's all going on.
Good. Nice to see there's no other message there. Then. thanks a lot, guys. Appreciate your time. OK, we stacked the parties tomorrow night, as you've heard. We know what these guys are doing and what the housemates are doing tomorrow night. We want to know what you're doing. Are you hosting an eviction party, building a sugar cube tower, or cracking out the cork for a game of Ibble Dibble? Our talking point today is, what are you doing for Finale Friday? Give us a call, 08709019070, 08709019070, littlebrother@e4.com. But on a different matter, you may think that over the last 63 days, you've seen everything there is to see on Big Brother, but there's one element that's remained mysterious, like the cities of gold. They've been the unsung heroes of Big Brother, the power behind the scenes, and many walk behind, many whisper in the ear, they are Big Brother. Some faces may be familiar to you, some may be new, but tonight they're coming out, facing the public and saying, I am what I am.
Hello, I'm Aidan and I'm the voice of Big Brother.
Hi, my name's Rob and I'm the voice of Big Brother.
The results of this week's nominations will be announced later this week.
Hello, my name's Helen and I am the voice of Big Brother.
You have failed this week's task.
Hello, I'm Simon, I'm the voice of Big Brother.
There are two people nominated for eviction this week.
Hi, my name's Deborah and I'm the voice of Big Brother.
Could all housemates please wear their microphones at all times?
Hello, I'm Frank, and I am the voice of Big Brother.
Housemates are reminded that discussion of nominations is strictly forbidden.
Hello, my name's Tess, and I am the voice of Big Brother.
The hot water is now on.
Any attempt to communicate with the outside world could result in your eviction.
Easy.
Hello there, okay. I'm riding side saddle now with senior producer Aidan for what might be the last time. Do you want to hold that for me, Aidan?
Sure.
I think you've graduated to that maybe boy band status now. You can hold your own mic and maybe we'll do a ballad together.
Thank you very much.
What's it been like being Big Brother?
I've loved it. I've loved every minute of it. Being the voice of Big Brother, as you discovered the other day, is pretty scary.
Horrible.
But along with the other 15 people who do it, I think we've all really enjoyed doing it most of the time.
It's been quite hard to remain anonymous, isn't the right word, but I guess, you know, ambiguous with the housemates.
It is when you're live on E4, but I think generally I tried not to meet the housemates before they went in. I wasn't involved in the audition process this time, and so that's helped a lot. I think for the people who met them before, it's very hard to then not admit
sure.
to being the person they know.
But what about your sympathies when, you know, they're feeling bad? I mean, how do you just remain anonymous?
Or? You just have to try and be professional and not give too much away, but obviously the tone of voice or the way you ask a question can actually give away quite a lot about what you're really thinking.
Sure.
So you just have to be careful, I suppose.
You've always got that great like trick of just like not speaking as well.
Well, there is that, yeah.
For about 5 minutes.
Silence is a really good way.
Get back to you.
Yeah.
Okay, your most memorable moment as the voice of Big Brother?
Most memorable probably is when I pressed the wrong button and the housemates heard Brian's second nomination. But
no!
Not quite.
what exactly happened?
I just pressed the wrong button. There's a diary room button, there's a house button, which is the voice of God, and I hit the wrong one, so sorry, that was me. But my favourite memory
were
was
probably... Were you showboating at the time, Aiden?
No. No, I just wasn't concentrating that, quite as much as I
should
have.
Did you have your feet up and you're just like...
No, no, you never do that. No, okay. No, I was just thinking about other things.
Can I say how much I'm loving the fact that these eviction lights just came down?
It's so exciting out here.
It's like we're at some kind of like Ronan Keating concert and you are Ronan.
It's fantastic. I'm getting butterflies just thinking about it.
Okay, so what's been going on in the house today?
Well, today it's been a lovely hot sunny day, so they've been doing a lot of sunbathing, a lot of speculating about Friday, which is when they think they're all leaving. Mm-hmm. And also tonight they've got their last meal. They're drinking Chateau Cos de Tourne, apparently, which
one
is
one of my favourite tipples.
And eating a lovely meal.
Mm-hmm. And if any of them guessed at all, they might be leaving tonight, because in light of this.
I really don't think they've got a clue. They're all assuming that they're going on Friday. And yeah. Although they've talked about it and speculated, I really don't think they have a clue.
Aiden, you're looking money, you are money. Thank you very much. Okay, coming up after we meet the Chinese astrologer, the lovely Paul Darby, take it to the bridge, Paul, and finding out what the future holds for the final four housemates. But right now, time for Connie Schalke.
Hi, I'm Connie Schalke. Four European women have posed in Playboy when they left the Big Brother house.
Welcome back to Big Brother's Little Brother. I hope you're all very well. Let's take a look at the Last Supper preparation thereof. Or Dean just messing around with a big white napkin. Okay, the end is nigh for one of the remaining housemates. In less than an hour, one of them will be told that they've got 90 minutes left to pack their bags and leave the house on Friday. They'll be back here with the rest of the finest, and so could you. Yesterday, we ran a competition to win two tickets to tomorrow's grand finale. We asked you, or we showed you a clip of the housemates soap opera, and we asked you, and I quote, which housemate was on the calendar in the background? It was, answer, Paul! Hello, Perky, how are you?
Mate, I'm all right, yeah.
All right, you got a winner there, so pick a winner.
Okay.
I thought it was an impossible question. I can't believe we got that many people got the question right.
Well, I'm going to go straight to the bottom, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
And it is that one there.
Which is?
Which is Emma from Liverpool.
Lovely. Oh, let's not give her out a phone number. We'll be in touch, and then you'll be in touch. Okay, the three remaining housemates will still have all to play for, and they are vying for votes tonight until the phone lines close tomorrow night. We've been looking at all the finalists' finest moments all week, and today it's the turn of the Porridge Princess, Miss Helen Adams.
I am honoured to be the only first hairdresser and the most Welsh person to have been on the Big Brother house. Rhoda is my best friend in the entire world. But Rhoda teaches dancing with me. Takes me serious.
Is there chicken and chickpeas?
I like Blinkin', I do.
Friday night and the lights are low. Looking out for a place to go. Where they play the right music. Getting in the swing. You come to look for a
now. In a way, Big Brother is the ultimate popularity contest. What is it about the four personalities that kept them in there in the house for 63 days, joined by a friend of the show, Chinese astrologer Paul Darby. Hello.
Hi, yeah.
How are you? All right.
Good to
be back. To get an insight into our housemates. Okay. What's the difference, firstly, between Chinese and traditional astrology?
Western astrology is based on solar, the sun, and the planets and the stars. Chinese is based on the cycles of the moon and the energies that were around when you were born.
See, I didn't know that, cycles of the moon, because if the moon, this is my philosophy, is that if the moon governs the tides, and we're 70% made up of water, therefore it must have some relevance on how we live our lives.
That's
okay,
spot on, yeah.
So let's talk through the housemates' different signs, starting with Helen.
Helen's a horse.
Right.
Stubborn, determined, very image conscious, lives in a little world of her own, really, and quite naive. So that's Helen.
That's very interesting, because Brian's a horse as well, if I'm right.
Brian is a horse, yes. They tend to have a sort of a quirky disposition, quite individualistic, great sense of humour.
Are they needy people, or...?
They tend to feed off an audience. They need to perform. Mm-hmm. They need to crack jokes. They need to be quite loud.
And do they get on together?
Horses get on pretty well in a team.
Right, okay, cool. Okay, now next up is Betty, Elizabeth.
Elizabeth's a tiger.
Now, what does that say about her?
Now, a tiger is like the mother figure. Very, very shrewd. Plays a lot of mind games. She can sum situations up very, very carefully. Sum people up very quickly. And know what to do, what's exactly right in the situation. Very special tiger.
And doesn't mind pictures being in papers. And what about Dean?
Dean is a rabbit.
Okay, and what does that tell us about him?
Well, he's called the negotiator. He likes to keep in the background, father figure, will come to the foreground to sort things out. He hates problems, he hates trouble. Mm-hmm. Sort things out, calms things down, and then disappears again. Very, very creative musically.
Isn't that mad how they all suit the characteristics of the different signs?
Well, the animals were the ones I expected to be there. The strong, for instance, there's no cockerel, there's no pig, there's no dog, which is what I would expect.
What sort of people are they? Are they quite individualistic?
The pig and the dog are sort of laid back. They don't like the spotlight. Mm-hmm. The cockerel can like the spotlight, but only for short periods of time. So they'd perhaps think of applying, but then they'd back out. They'd think, oh no, I couldn't take it for that long.
Right, okay. And why do you think it is that these four have lasted the longest out of all of them? Is it because of that?
Well, the rabbit and the tiger are playing mind games. They can sum people up and stay in the background and keep out of trouble. Also, the mother and father. I think if the housemates voted, they would vote for Elizabeth and Dean to win.
Very interesting.
But the horses are there because of their personality and also because they're determined and stubborn.
Okay, so who do you think will be out tonight then, in light of the different predictions and the different...
It's stuff? Very difficult because the public have got a different perception of what's going on. Mm-hmm. And I think the public will go for the horses. I think that Brian could very well win. I think that Helen could be second, and I think Dean will come out tonight.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah.
And do you think the signs have affected the housemates' chances of winning in that respect?
Well, in that the tiger and the rabbit stand a very good chance of winning, but that they're a bit too calm for the public. Yeah. As I say, if the housemates were voting for them, they'd win hands down, I think.
Sure.
But they're not strong enough to the public to be sort of considered as a leading personality.
Okay, you're also a feng shui expert and a consultant. You've done some stuff for us. You looked at the house before the show started up, and weirdly, the predictions that you've made have sort of come true, haven't they?
Yeah.
Especially I'm thinking about Bubble's bed.
That was a shame for Bubble, but he did bags it, didn't he? It was his own fault.
Oh, he loved it. What did he say? He wanted that bed desperately. But,
that's right.
But what was it you said about the bed?
Well, it was in the northeast, very active area of energy. Excellent for a study, excellent for a living room, but no good for sleep.
Mm.
So emotional roller coaster, aggression, tears, and possible physical injury, and they all happened.
Of course, the trouble in the garden as well with Penny and Stuart.
That's right, with
Stuart and Emma.
The straight lines pointing at those little bits. What is useful to note is the way that they use the so-called love shack. Elizabeth and Dean used that early on to recharge the batteries. And it's interesting that Paul and Helen used it to do exactly the same kind of thing, to get comfort.
Excellent. Paul, delighted to have you with us. Stay with us for the talking point. Our talking point today, what are you doing for Finale Friday? Paul Clarke is in with us as well. We should have a Jonathan from London online. Hello, Jonathan.
Hello, Dermot, you gorgeous, surprisingly non-stopping skinhead.
Hello, Jonathan, how are you?
I'm very good. Can I just get something on my chest about that feng shui bloke?
Yeah.
He's fooling no one in those bloody kung fu pyjamas. He knows less about it than I do. The straight lines pointing to the bits in the garden. What's that all about?
Jonathan, that's one of our experts. You can't talk about him like that.
You didn't say that when I did your house.
Okay, so, Jonathan, what are you doing for Finale Friday?
Oh, we've got a big evening planned. Last year we had a big get-together, big dinner. This year, we're going to hold a big fancy dress dinner.
Nice. And are you coming as the housemates, or how does that work?
Of course we're coming as the housemates. Otherwise, why would we be doing it?
I just thought there was maybe a kind of a French, like, Edwardian maybe tip going on in your house.
But we're doing Cavaliers and Roundheads. Big brother.
Who are you going to go as?
Oh, I'm obviously going to be Stuart, the slightly older man with the alarming gum problem. I do a very good impersonation of Stuart beating Emma down in the jacuzzi. Sadly, you need to be here for it. And I've also mastered his going high cry of, I'm coming home!
And who do you want to win?
I like the rest of the nation, of course. My heart's with young Brian. Send him up above to cheer us all up.
Excellent stuff. We want you to come. I know you've got a party tomorrow, but I desperately have been after you to come down.
I want to come over.
Series.
I'm going to try and squeeze it. But you see, I want to be here with everyone because my wife, Jane, is going to be done up as Helen.
Yeah.
Our friend Emily, she's going to be Nasty Naz. Yeah. We've got David Baddiel's coming. He doesn't know this yet, but we're going to force him to dress up as Dean, I think. he plays the guitar and he's a little bit dull. Alan Davis does a great impersonation of Paul. He's going to be here.
Cool.
Oh, and Jane's mum is going to come as Elizabeth, although the fact that she actually has a sense of humour should really disqualify her for that role.
Is it
my imagination, or is Elizabeth going out with Harpo Marx?
That's where I'm going to wrap it. Thanks a lot, Jonathan. Make a show. Try and come down tomorrow. We get back for the party. Thank you very much. Okay, who's next up? Is it Emma from London as well?
Hello, darling.
Hello, Emma. How are you?
I'm good. How are you, darling?
I'm very well, thank you.
Good. Hello, Paul.
Hiya.
Hi, you all right?
Yeah, I'm not too bad.
Why do I
know your voice?
This is Baby Spice.
Ah.
Oh. Hello, how are you? All right.
Hello. Good. I'm trying to get back. I've just been to Liverpool. I'm trying to get back for the show tonight, so I'm rushing.
Cool. And who do you want out tonight?
Who do I want out tonight? Mm-hmm. Well, I love them all, but I think it's time for Elizabeth to go, really,
okay,
isn't it?
Okay, cool. A lot of people saying that. And what are you doing for tomorrow night?
Do you know what, Dermot? As you know, we work very hard, don't we? I'm going to be working, but I've asked for a TV in my dressing room.
Nice touch. Oh, nice touch. Thanks a lot, babe. Thank you very much.
I need to see it. Thank you, darling.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Okay,
bye.
A couple of emails here. Angie in Doncaster having a Big Brother party with loads of cider and wine. That could be dangerous. Teresa is having a huge street party in Belfast for 200 locals.
Wow.
And hi, Dermot. We can't wait till tomorrow night. We've organised our own Big Brother party in the street. We're going to stop the traffic, put TVs and party tables on the road. Sharon in Gravesend. And we're having a dress-up as Disco Diva Helen party. All of us have the most fabulous blonde wigs and glittering dresses. We brought CDs of the National Anthem and Worst accompanied the dancing. That's from George and Dave in Edinburgh. Wow. Paul, you've been an absolute diamond, I have to say, this week. Thank you very much. We've just got a couple of presents for you here, my friend. Ooh, okay, here we go. Just like to unwrap them for you.
For
okay.
Me?
Yep.
Wow.
Got some starting products. Got a picture of me and you.
That's brilliant.
And lastly, seeing as though you like to live your life as an international pop star, we thought we'd get you tickets to see a real international pop star. You can take Helen along if you like to go and see the fantastic Robbie Williams.
Thank you very
my pleasure. Paul Clark, everybody. I have to say, thank you very much, Paul. I have to say, very exciting show tomorrow. One-hour special right from the heart of things. We report on the grand build-up of the finale, joined by the next person to leave Big Brother and all eight evictees to meet on TV for the very first time. See you tomorrow. God bless. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Bye. And don't miss the last Little Brother with Dermot tomorrow, same time. Over on Channel 4 in half an hour, it's The Eviction with Davina. Then at 8:30, we're back to E4 for the reactions live. Next on E4, Tony and Mr. C are going canvassing crazy in the first of two Hollyoaks.